Hello everyone, good morning to all of you. Today we are going to start with the next content from the same topic, that is reproduction in lower and higher plant. Before to start this lecture, let us take some review of our previous lecture. In last lecture we discussed about the pollination, definition of pollination, types of pollination, various agents, biotic, abiotic agents involved in the pollination, and on the basis of these agents, the various types of pollination. Then lastly, we discussed about the outbreeding devices and its necessity in the mode of pollination. In today's lecture, we are going to study the few content like the pollen pistil interaction, then the artificial hybridization, and most important point in this topic, that is the double fertilization, the process and its significance. So let us start the today's lecture with pollen pistil interaction. We know this term, pollen and pistil. Pollen, it is the male, and pistil, it is the female. So male reproductive whorl in flower is androecium, and member of androecium is a stamen, and the structure of androecium, which consists of three parts like the anther, stick, anther, connective and filament. Inside the anther, the pollen grains are present, and we know that the pollen grain how develops into the male gametophyte in our previous lecture. So the pollen, it is the male reproductive structure, and that pollen, it transfers towards the pistil. What is pistil? It is the female reproductive structure. We know that female reproductive whorl is gynoecium, member of gynoecium is carpel, also it is called as the pistil. So pollen, it is male, and pistil, it is the female. So interaction between this male and female, that we are going to study in this point, in pollen pistil interaction. This pollen pistil interaction, it starts with the mechanism of pollination. What is pollination? It is the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma, male to female. It is called as the pollination, and this process, it ends with the fertilization. Fertilization, that is the fusion of male with female parts. So what is the exact definition of pollen pistil interaction? Whatever the events which starts from the deposition of pollen grain on the stigma, then when that pollen grains are deposited on the stigma, then the entry of a pollen tube in the ovule through synergids, all these events togetherly considered as pollen pistil interaction. So from the deposition of pollen grain on the stigma, then the development of pollen tube, entry of pollen tube in the ovule through the synergid, all these events, they are called as the pollen pistil interaction. So in the world of process of deposition of pollen grain on the stigmatic surface of the flower, there are so many pollen grains they deposit on the stigma. There are number of pollen grains which deposits over the stigma, but only the compatible and right pollen grain, it is accepted by the stigmatic surface, and rest of the pollen grains they discard by the pistil or the female reproductive structures. So here it is diagram which clears our pollen pistil interaction concept. Here it is stigma, it is the platform for the deposition of pollen grain. Then it is the long tubular structure, it is called as the style, and it is the solen structure, we call it as the ovary. Inside the ovary, there is presence of ovules on the inner wall of the ovary, and at the center here, there is presence of embryo sac. We know that structure of anatropous ovule. Here the deposition of pollen grain on the stigma, deposition of pollen grain on the stigma, development of pollen grain into the pollen tube, then that pollen tube, it travels through this tubular style and it enters through the embryo sac or female gametophyte through the opening. It is called as the micropyle. So all these events, from the deposition of pollen grain, then development of pollen grain to pollen tube, then pollen tube travels through this style and that pollen tube enters into this ovule, all these events togetherly called as the pollen pistil interaction. It is not easier because so many pollen grains, they are deposited over this stigmatic surface, and only the right and compatible pollen grain, it is accepted by the stigmatic surface and which facilitate the process of pollen grain germination. So what is the property of a stigma? That stigma, it bears the watery and sugary secretion, watery and sugary secretions. That means that the stigmatic surface, it bears the various types of the nutrients, and these nutrients, they are absorbed by the water togetherly with the nutrients and sugar content. It is absorbed by the deposited pollen grain where it germinates and it gives rise to the pollen tube. And this pollen tube, it further travels through the special type of the proteins, with the special type of the proteins present over this stigma, and the chemicals which facilitates the entry of that pollen tube through this long style, and at the end that pollen tube, it comes in contact with this opening of the ovule. It is called as the micropyle. Then that pollen tube enters through this area where at the center there is presence of egg, and at its lateral side there is presence of synergids. We know the structure of anatropous ovule. The synergids, importance of synergids is here because synergids, it bears the filiform apparatus, and that filiform apparatus attracts that pollen tube. So that pollen tube enters into the ovule, and all these events togetherly called as the pollen pistil interactions. So this pollen pistil interaction, it is very much a significant process as it facilitates the process of fertilization, and the mechanism of sexual reproduction is completed, and result of sexual reproduction is the formation of seed. This pollen pistil interaction, we can artificially germinate the pollen grains. How? By using the synthetic medium, that is use of sucrose, which helps to form the pollen tube in vitro. And again, if we are going to add the boric acid, it also helps to accelerate the pollen germination mechanisms. So in this pollen pistil interaction, the deposition of pollen grain on the stigmatic surface, here the deposition of pollen grain on the stigmatic surface, that pollen grain absorbs the water, nutrients, proteins, sugary content present on this stigmatic surface, then that pollen grain undergoes germination, which results into the formation of pollen tube. Then that pollen tube, it travels through the various chemicals through this long style, and it enters inside the ovule, and the entry of a pollen tube inside the ovule takes place, which facilitates the process of fertilization. It is all about the pollen pistil interactions. The question may be asked on this content like the describe the mechanism of pollen pistil interaction. Next point is artificial hybridization. Various horticulturists or agriculturists, they use this mechanism, that is the artificial hybridization of crop improvement. So for the crop improvement, this artificial hybridization is used. How? That agriculturist or horticulturist, they take away the pollen grains from the plant by the help of forceps. Here it is forceps, and these are the pollen grains which are removed with the help of this forceps, and the desired type of pollen grains are dusted artificially again on this emasculated flower. And the process, next step after the emasculation, is the application of bag to avoid the contact of unwanted pollen grains. So in case of artificial hybridization, the desired type of pollen grain we can deposit on the flower, that is the process of emasculation, that is the removal of stamens, well before anthesis, that is the formation of pollen grain via the forceps. Then the dusting of the desired pollen grain, then the cover that flower with the help of polythene bag to avoid the contamination of unwanted pollen grain. So by this method we can transfer the desired type of pollen grain on our plant. So this method, it is very much significant to improve the crop varieties. It is about the artificial hybridization. Our next point and the most important point in this topic is the double fertilization. As we know that in angiospermic plant, the process of double fertilization is unique, which is not found in any other plant group like the algae, fungi, bryophytes, pteridophytes and gymnosperms. So the double fertilization, it is the very much significant and the key characteristic of angiospermic plants. Let us come to know about the discovery of this double fertilization. It is discovered by the scientist Navaschin in the liliaceous plants like the Lilium and Fritillaria. The process of double fertilization, it is the complex process which is found in flowering, that is the angiospermic plants. What is a double fertilization? Double means twice, and fertilization means the fusion of male and female gamete. Here it takes place twice. Don veles fertilization hota. What is the exact definition of double fertilization? In double fertilization, we must know that at the time of development of male gametophyte, at the end there is formation of two male gametes which are non-motile in nature and they are haploid in nature. आपणाला माहिती पाहिजे, आपण ज्यावेळेस मेल गॅमेटोफाइट डेव्हलपमेंट पाहिला त्यामध्ये आपणाला दोन नॉन मेल मेल गॅमेट भेटलेले आहेत की जे हॅप्लॉइड आहेत, आणखी त्याच दोन नॉन मोटाईल मेल गॅमेटचा वापर या ठिकाणी आपण डबल फर्टिलायझेशन मध्ये करणार आहोत, म्हणजे फर्स्ट मेल गॅमेट आणखी सेकंड मेल गॅमेट. इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ डबल फर्टिलायझेशन, द फ्युजन ऑफ फर्स्ट मेल गॅमेट, पहिला मेल गॅमेट, इट फ्युजेस विथ द एग egg in the ovule, and the second male gamete, it fuses with the secondary nucleus in the ovule. म्हणजे इथे दोन male gamete जे आपल्याला male gametophyte मधून भेटतात त्यापैकी पहिला जो आहे तो एग बरोबर फ्यूज होतो आणि दुसरा जो आहे तो सेकंडरी न्यूक्लियस बरोबर होतो, and this process is called as the double fertilization. Double fertilization. So the fusion of first male gamete with the egg And second male gamete with the secondary nucleus is called as the double fertilization. And the way of traveling of this male gamete through the pollen tube, it is called as the siphonogamy. What is siphonogamy? Non-motile male gamete travels through the pollen tube. It is called as the siphonogamy. Next, there are various ways to enter that pollen tube in the ovule, like the porogamy, chalazogamy, and mesogamy. The definitions may be asked to you. What is porogamy, siphonogamy, chalazogamy, and mesogamy? Here there is entry. Entry kona cha hai? Entry jee ahe ti ahe pollen tube chi. Mhanje ithe apnala sagalyat mahatvacha common ka asnar ahe tina tiga madhye pan entry of pollen tube in the ovule. Mhanje pollen tube chi entry ovule madhye honyache je prakar ahe te teen prakare hoo shakto. Ek ahe porogamy, dusra ahe chalazogamy, and tisra ahe mesogamy. Mag kuthun, what is porogamy? In porogamy, the entry of a pollen tube, it is through the micropyle. Ithun मायक्रोपाइल मधून जर ओपनिंग एंट्री जर झाली पोलन ट्यूबची ओव्युल मध्ये तर त्याला काय बोलतात पोरोगॅमी. व्हाट इज चलाजोगॅमी? द नेम इटसेल्फ इंडिकेट्स द एंट्री ऑफ अ पोलन ट्यूब फ्रॉम द चलाजा वरून चलाजा मधून येतो. अँड व्हाट इज मेसोगॅमी? द एंट्री ऑफ अ पोलन ट्यूब थ्रू द एंटिगमेंट्स द आउटर कवरिंग्स ऑफ द एम्ब्रियो सॅक टू आउटर अँड इनर एंटिगमेंट्स हियर इट इज मेसोगॅमी. So, the way of entry of the pollen tube into the ovule, it is of three types. Porogamy via micropyle, chalazogamy via chalaza, and mesogamy via integuments. So, these are the ways to enter the pollen tube in the ovary. Then, let us come to know the process of double fertilization. We know that double fertilizations means the fertilizations which takes place by two times in two steps. So in first fertilization and in second fertilization, the process of first fertilization, it is called as the syngamy. Process of first fertilization is called as the syngamy, and process of second fertilization is called as the triple fusion. It's called as the triple fusion. Here there is procedure of double fertilization, first fertilization or syngamy, and second fertilization or triple fusion. So what happen in first fertilization and what happen in second fertilization? Here the fusion of male gamete in first fertilization also. Here the fusion of male gamete in second fertilization also. So in first fertilization, let us come to this diagram. In first fertilization, let us come to concentrate first over this area. That is the ovule. That is the ovule. Inside the ovule, there is presence of embryo sac or female gametophyte. In this female gametophyte, we know that at the center, there is presence of egg. These are the two synergids. At the center, there is presence of secondary nucleus. And these are the three antipodal cells. We know the nature of egg, it is haploid. Nature of secondary nucleus, it is diploid. So the fusion of these male gametes, first male gamete or syngamy, here syngamy or first fertilization, here the male gamete which is first, that first male gamete, it fuses with the egg. We know the nature of male gamete, it is haploid, that is N. We know the nature of egg, which is again haploid, N plus N, 2N means diploids. So the result of syngamy or first fertilization, that is the fusion of male gamete, haploid male gamete with the haploid egg cell, it gives rise to the diploid zygote, and further that zygote develops into diploid embryo. The result of first fertilization is development of zygote, and zygote leads to the formation of embryo which is diploid. then come towards the second fertilization or triple fusion. Triple fusion. Here it is second male gamete, which is again haploid, and the nature of secondary nucleus is diploid, that is 2n. So that second male gamete, it fuses with the diploid secondary nucleus. So n plus 2n is equal to 3n, which gives rise to the triploid primary endosperm nucleus, which gives rise to finally the endosperm, that is the nutritive tissue. And this nutritive tissue, which is formed by the second fertilization or triple fusion, it is the type of vegetative fertilization. So the process of double fertilization, it is carried out with the help of two steps: first fertilization or syngamy, which results into the formation of the diploid zygote, which gives rise to the embryo, and the second fertilization, that is the triple fusion, it gives rise to the triploid primary endosperm nucleus, which develops into the triploid endosperm. The process of first fertilization or syngamy, it is the type of generative fertilization, and the process of second fertilization or triple fusion, it is called as the vegetative fertilization. So this process of double fertilization, which is the unique characteristic of flowering plant or the angiospermic plant, it is the most important feature in the angiospermic or flowering plant, which is not found in rest of the plant group. Then let us come to know the significance of this process. As we know that the double fertilization, it is the unique feature of angiospermic plant, which ensures the development of seeds, storage of food, and all this happens only if the egg is fertilized. Then again, next significance here: in a double fertilization, the diploid zygote, result of first fertilization, which further gives rise to the embryo, and that embryo gives rise to the new plant. So the development of new plant from the diploid zygote, which develops into the embryo, it is possible. Then next, the result of second fertilization, that is the triploid primary endosperm nucleus, which develops into the nutritive endosperm tissue. And the process of double fertilization restores the diploid condition by the fusion of haploid male gamete with the haploid female gamete through the first fertilization or syngamy. And all this process of double fertilization, it helps to avoid the polyembryony. So this double fertilization, it is a unique feature of angiospermic plants, which is not found in the rest of the plant group. Therefore, the number of angiospermic plant in all the plant groups, it is more and advanced. It is having the advanced features. So the question on this content, that is double fertilization, it may be asked on the long answer question, like the what is double fertilization, describe the process of double fertilization, or give its significance separately. And the diagram of double fertilization, it may be asked for sketch and label question. So in today's lecture, we completed the pollen pistil interaction, artificial hybridization, and the most important part in this topic, that is the double fertilization, its definition, process, and significance. So in next lecture, we are going to start with the types of endosperm, its various types, its mode of development, and the embryo development. So be prepared with this point, as it is very much important for your exam point of view. Thank you.